you are doing now, your classroom. Okay. So today I'm going to talk about Behat. So maybe that how many of us have heard or might have used Behat in any projects. Okay. So why you have this chosen Behat for your project? Can someone answer?
Whatever you have, that is, you can ask immediately. I'm happy with that.
it's a data way. I cover Behat, Behat, Drupal extension, Behat insertion, navigation, test execute on the console, area for example, and how we can regression, how we can implement each testing in VR. So, as I mentioned, that Behat is a behavior driven man. So, this is also one more thing. Why it is called stylized? Because everything is understandable in the human, that this is a human language. When we do the programming, so we understand that the first system of language, but it's more of like where the client can easily understand what we have done for the client, and the developer team can understand the client business. So that's why it's a more of a development. In Behat, we use the method to test from the test name and test format from the control. We can use the black box drivers and use like driver to test it in the browser. So we might see in that format also. So we can see whatever we are actually in the console, we can see the behavior when in the black. Most of the cases client asks for this thing, right? So if you are executing the system constructing from the console, client won't have this possibility because client won't know that what's going to the console. So it looks like black or it looks like white text. So in that case it's difficult to be the client. So in that case we can use the web driver available like me. Help us to get the test of the project. So, Drupal extension, so this is a Drupal extension, and the Drupal extension is more, but they have, we can test anything. It's not about Drupal, it's not about the API. Right? So, with the Drupal extension, we get more features here. Then we can set up a test data with the help of Brush, the Drupal API. We can define that we have 4-5 sections. We can define this classic section like footer, header, content section, like sidebar, next sidebar. We can define all sections. We can test these sessions especially in a lot of pages or in a lot of sections. And it is also helpful that when we want to extend the functionality, like we can indicate the extension to Drupal books also. So that in that case, we don't need to write functions to execute in different cases. So if we use the Drupal API, so more of the Drupal books can be invoking the Behat API. So that the Behat test, you can go there easily without writing a lot of coding. Like that, we will be for the we send the function code stuff. So there I think the solution. Your solution can be done in different ways. You know, like it's probably up to you and your machine has compatibility of that. Whether you can use the GitHub, you can use Path, you can use Composer. So there are just use Composer. So using the Composer and this is a whole other thing. We usually install Behat as specific to the one project, right? If you want, this is a standalone application. If we want to install Behat at the system level, we can test more project with a single Drupal installation, single Behat setup. So there are two types of installations, standalone and system level. Yeah.
Quick setup first, administration for this. Standalone or.
Yeah. So you can use both of these systems. Yes.
There are any limitations?
Any
limitations?
Any limitations of the solution?
No. How many one we have can test on the get
No, there is no limitation. So, if you have installed one Behat in the system, there is installation. So, only when you can create a lot of directories specific to the test or price, and in these directories, you can specify to their code. So, you don't need to go to the Behat every time. So, your code is one, but you are extending from the directories. Right. So, this is the advantage of them.
I'm just getting confused about the UDD and PDD. Can you?
It's the behavior variable rhythm.
And what is the difference between PDD and PDD?
So, PDD is when before developing anything, you first write a test according to the feature. Suppose you want to develop logging. You first write a test and test as a method, so that you are passing some values for credentials and then you are expecting a logging. Because there is no code written, first time you run the test, you should fail. That's the principle of PDD. You start with a failure and then you start writing code instead of failure. Right? So you follow a reverse approach. So generally, in classic development, we have you first develop, there is a bug, and then you fix. So you have to start the reverse way. You first write the test.
And then you write code. Part of the thing, for example, you do is an example that client is doing a test. You create a scenario and you say, I'm fitting this, but I should say that I'm fitting this. So, whenever you have PDD, you are actually doing some kind of PDD.
Sure, but there's no dependence on the sequence of events. In PDD, you can first write your code and then you can run your acceptance test to see whether it main advantage is it is in simple English sentences, easier to write and understand.
I would like to add for the major difference between PDD and PDD or IRC is in PDD we are code specific. We are writing code in the test. Only to test our specific method. Whereas in PDD we have a general English statement where the users will be generated. In PDD, you need to run a code suite to run one user story. Whereas in PDD, you do the same thing, you call out functions, but we have a user story written in plain English, which is understandable to the PA.
That's why it's called SIS, as we can use testing the site. So that's it. So this is the you have a clear picture of the things. You have a test scenario, but you have at more lines here that we give in India. Will be under PDD, don't follow this.
I think even if I follow PDD, according to what we do right now, at best for a table in this way, I don't need to run a complete, for example, scenario that you do for PDD. I can do the same thing for the PDD as well.
Yeah.
Just the language that is different. So
this is so the way difference between that you know that in BBB your client is also understanding the work to
IBB. Yeah.
So in the BBB is not possible. Yeah. So this is the way we can do that. That way
Behat basically giving me a functionality that I can write my test in the English way in English.
Yes.
That is what Behat does. It is not the origination of PDD, there can be multiple PDDs in the world. Right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So, on installation, we can do in different ways. We can test it through the system based on the standard application. So, I have here the system based application. So, here I can show you the JSON file. Yeah. So in a composer.json file, as mentioned here, that it is more of an open extension. So if you take that I have specified a version of the extension and assign to that will be like the solution. So after that I run. So after I run super compose and install all the libraries or simple issues of this particular because producer is simply inspired by or inspired from the computer world. So it downloads all the required libraries and all the components of the symphony or the required external libraries or the transfer of the source. Whatever the event and the required library will be stored in this
question dependency for the style.
So to learn that Behat is system meeting at least a minimum question required is 85.3. So here we can check Behat, and after that we can add a short of Behat and we use it and file console. So the Saturday and then in the next more of the next session. So it will add Behat as a in my system, and after that I will be able to call Behat from my system. So
I can test CSS of my website. So in
only after that, you can create your own library also, because of your extension also. So that can be rooted in the Behat application. Like here. So, this letter, sometimes we can be like a test. We do in the general English or the Behat English, we write something which is not understandable to the system, or we want to reduce it in some cases. So in we can use letter. Like the message letter dot message dot message class and error error dot message dot message error. These all things we can define a lot of more things we can define in Behat library. So this is a configuration that can be done once. You can keep adding to this schematic section, or even you can add a black box library, you can add a selenium library, you can add a Drupal email library to Behat. So using Drupal email library, you will be able to access creating a node, creating a text module, or adding an entity node. So you don't need to write a lot of tests or a lot of lines to get that for the execution. So when we initiate Behat first type, it creates a folder feature. So in which type we have initiated, so we can discuss it to the client directly. That Behat test is a client directly where I have initiated, in which I have initiated Behat. So it creates a future folder inside. The future folder is keep the bootstrap. After that, these are my test which can be written in the Behat. So bootstrap contains the future of future context. So by default, we have dot YML, whatever the context I have done here. These gets communicated with these classes. These are the code of the security, code of the Drupal also. So here, based on the requirement, we can upgrade or we can extend the feature functionalities. Sometimes we need a simple test, sometimes we need a web-based test. So these are tests can be integrated here. So inside you can write a function. Most of the time, we get some customization. We do the customization that which might be not related to the core of the system. So we have to do some customization that way. So we can add more function here to extend the code feature. Once they have initiated, you can check the where we have initiated. You can check Behat is working just by run. So it will show you. So Drupal system, so Drupal is such a driver, so which all things we have available we can use in my system for the dynamic test. So these all things like given, then these are the few words which you know that makes a permission. Like these are memory, then to start with the test, I don't take a scenario. The first time I have to go to human only. So I can't do then when Drupal. Normally we think we have to start from somewhere and then do the permissions. There is some formatting of formatting issues, like declination issues or syntax issues. So if you are like, why it is, I don't know, just do that what we are doing and what we are doing. Right. So in this way, we can check all the hard settings properly working. So after that, yeah, so we can say that we are ready to write a test. So this is the solution concept. We can confirm that application or that the Behat is the part of our system. So we have one example, like some SEO folk told me, told my client that some H1 leads in the so the picture is create a picture that actual relation you want to check actual as in digital and it will be at least R in actual test. Okay, so scenarios, first of all that this is a standard of package of Behat. First of all that we need to find, we have to find a picture. What kind of picture it is, right? And in the picture we have this like stylized, like in order to check as a visitor, we have to find the room. Like whenever we test any web application or any application, first of all we are a visitor. Second, we are a user. Third, we have a specific room. So we have a level, site, visitor, anonymous, it can be anonymous also, or it is authenticated user system. So after that we have a any specific room here, like it could be admin also, editor also, or it could be a SEO user. Another tools we have to know that we can test. Right? So in this scenario we have to just define what function is performing. It is, you know, that it could be a matter of this Google story also. So it doesn't matter that we're over so after the scenario, you have to start with given. Given I do, first of all, that here is a example. I have validate actual in the content pages, right? In the content pages, as a actual tag. So what is my acceptance criteria? That I go to any page, I click on that, and then on that specific, or middle of that specific page, and check whether the title is in actual tag or not. Is that in actual tag or not? So this is my requirement. So these all things are just showing here in the Windows format. So it can be displayed.
Here, I search for is not this generally this is the flow of Behat. But when they require such kind of thing, I can explain that in future context of PHP file. So by default, it takes an argument from the code exactly, and you can add the logic here, and after that, you can add that in that language, in Behat language. So it will exclude that brilliance.
person for potential names. Yeah. All right. So I'm done. Questions?
Yeah, if I want to cover all the scenarios in page, then I have to write a lot of
all the scenarios in
one page. It looks like a code which is required for writing your presentation. It's what time of another place. And how do you actually involve it? Like someone can handle a such a person in a day. How much effort do you need for it?
Yeah, so writing this little page over time in Behat. But when you do that, if you have a good skill in writing methods, you can have a it may seem to us very easier. So you just know that kind of things are coming into your code, getting into that thing. Then I think that's why it's very easy to do it. So it is easy. And because that's a lot of things that I do this.
So that if you can call the code, you will have to
showed an additional feature for the DM. It's a nice feature. Now, we apply this kind of options to give you more accessibility to what will make my job easier.
Yeah.
But my actual question was like, how much,
Thank you.
in the